Undercoating is always the initial stage of painting a miniature. It's the primer that allows the paint to grip onto the model and so is very important. Now there are two methods of doing it. You can either spray or you can paint it on by hand, and I'm going to show you now how to use both. The first method I'm going to show you is how to use spray. And spray is what I use almost all the time because it's a very fast method and it gives a great surface to paint onto. Now there are two main colours that we use. There's Skull White and Chaos Black. Chaos Black is the one I use most often because I find it really helps out with shading on miniatures. But Skull White's great if you want to do something that's very bright, like say bright yellow for example. Now what you need to do is find yourself an old wooden stick like this one here. You can see I use this one a lot. And grab yourself some double-sided tape or some adhesive putty and just stick down a layer like this. And this gives me a surface that I can stick my miniatures to temporarily whilst I spray them. So there we go. Now I've got some Space Marines here. I'm not going to spray all of them. I'm just going to put a few on. But you can see that if I stick them down on here, then when I'm spraying, I can pick up the stick and really move it around and get the spray into all the little nooks and crannies on the miniature. Now you have to use this stuff in a well-ventilated area. So I'm going to go outside and spray a bunch of these Marines now and show you exactly how it works. Okay, so here I am outside and it's a bit cold today, so I'm going to be quick about this. Just give the can a good shake before you start to use it and grab your miniatures. And well, you can see I've got here a box. This is to catch any excess spray that goes past the miniatures. All you do is hold your can about 30 centimetres away from them and just start spraying in bursts like this. Now having the stick means I can move them around and I can get all the details on them and get a nice good coverage across the whole model. Once I'm done, in about 15 minutes it'll be dry, and then we're ready to start painting. I've left the miniatures for about 15 minutes now, and like you can see, it's given me a really nice smooth black coat all over the model. So it's perfect for painting on the base paints. So I've done the same for 9 of these Space Marines in the squad, but the last one, I'm going to use him to show you how to use the paint on version of Undercoat instead. Now it's a very specific colour for this. It's called Imperial Primer, and it's one of the technical paints. This paint's a lot thicker than the other ones in the range, so you've got to give it a really good shake. You might need to stir it too. I've already been stirring this one, so it's ready for me to go. But you'll notice immediately how thick it is. Get yourself a nice large brush. I'm using a large brush here. Load it up with some paint and pop it onto your palette. And this is just so you can control how much is on your brush. Don't water it down very much, if at all. You might need to when it starts drying out on your palette, but the more water you add to it, the harder it will be for it to grip to the miniature. Now there's no great trick to this. Just grab your model and start slapping this paint on and it will give you that black coat. You've got to work all over the miniature, so make sure that you work your brush into all those little details, all those little nooks and crannies, so you get it everywhere. But be careful that you don't put so much on that you start clogging up the detail. You just want a nice even coat all over him. Now this paint dries pretty quickly, about 5 or 10 minutes should be just fine. Okay, so there we go. I've finished undercoating all the miniatures now, and this one's been done with Imperial Primer and this one with Chaos Black Spray. And you can see the end result's very similar, but using the spray was much faster. So always remember, you absolutely must undercoat your miniatures because it's what your paints cling to. If you choose to use the spray, be sure to do it in a very well ventilated area, preferably outdoors. Be sure to completely cover the model, but don't go crazy and put so much paint on that you start clogging the detail.